Hi, I'm Orville, and we've got Jay Duerr from LMC here at the factory. He's going to show us how to rebuild one of our LMC 8-inch chuck from our ST15 lathe. Now, the chuck we're going to be working on is pretty clean. We follow a regular maintenance program of disassembling and cleaning our chucks every 6 months here at the factory. Your chuck will last longer, and it will be easier to maintain if you perform this maintenance at least once a year. Once you've got your chuck clean and reassembled, you're gonna wanna give it 3 full pumps of Mobile XHP 222. It's one of the grease we use here at Haas. With that said, let's rebuild this chuck.
Okay, so Orville, the first thing we're gonna do, this is an 8-inch chuck, so in this circumstance, the back plate or the mounting adapter is mounted into the chuck.
Okay.
On some of your other size chucks, maybe it's a 10-inch chuck,
yeah.
It's kind of an exact opposite. This will be mounted up first, and then the chuck will be mounted to the adapter. Just kind of depends on the size of the spindle and the size of the chuck for the machine, but in this circumstance.
Okay.
So the first thing we're gonna wanna do is remove these bolts.
So is there anything critical, you know, under this, any spring tension that we need to worry about as far as when you're trying to pull this up?
Now, this is kind of a press fit at this point.
Okay.
I always like to mark things so I know and I can align later on down the line.
Okay.
There's only two ways that I can position this.
Right.
It can be 180 and 180 because of these jack holes.
Okay.
So I'm going to use the same bolts that were holding the adapter in. Now, to essentially, with small turns and pressure, release this adapter from the main chuck body. This is normally where you would put in parts rest or things along those lines. Let's say you're machining a part and you want to hold it out to a certain position.
Right, right.
But so that's what these holes are here. So we're going to install some bolts there.
Okay.
It's going to allow that chuck to stand off the work set.
Just to
get it off the,
off the table.
Correct. It's going to act as like a little bit, you know, a bar stool for lack of a better term. This is the shifter that attaches to the hydraulic union through the draw nut that moves back and forth and opens and closes the jaws for the chuck. It should be easy to just slide out. Again, you've maintained it well. And there's the shifter of the chuck. Now you can even see there's a chip right there.
So this is where all the buildup would happen.
Correct. You get it in the main body of the chuck, you get it in the shifter, you get it all in this area. And what happens is that this doesn't move smoothly inside the body of the chuck, and these jaws don't move in and out, and you lose grip force. And so you're not gonna be holding that part as tight. As we clean off this grease, you're gonna have marks on the chuck that match and correspond with jaw one. So this is gonna be the jaw one position. And you're gonna match it with the jaw one on the front, and you're gonna match it with the jaw one on the body of the chuck. Correct. So we're gonna set this aside. Now we're gonna go ahead and remove those master jaws. Again, Haas has done a great job of maintaining this chuck, so we don't have a lot of that, you know, debris and things along and cruds inside of there. So you may have to work at this a little bit harder than we're gonna show you right now when you're doing a field, you know, service. So we're gonna slide this first jaw out. Set it aside. We're gonna slide this second jaw out. Set it aside. And then we'll go ahead and do the third one. So we've removed all these jaws, Orville, and what we wanna make sure is that these jaws all go back into the same slot. And the way that you're gonna ensure that that happens is that, let me flip this chuck body back over for you. And you can see that each one of these jaws is marked. One, two, three. Cool. And it corresponds with the markings on the outside of the chuck. You can see number one, number one, number two, number two, number three, number three. So you would always orient and match these numbers up to keep that chuck reassembled in the exact same way it was coming out of the factory.
What if there's an issue where, you know, someone accidentally put jaw one into jaw three? I mean,
So the biggest thing that's gonna happen, especially on a chuck that's been used out in the field, as that chuck gets used, that gets worn in together and they become a matching set. So you put that chuck together and all of a sudden you say, I've repaired this chuck and now I'm getting worse runout and worse repeatability than I did before I started. Then you may want to go back and make sure that you've aligned
everything
is put right back in the same position.
Got it.
We can show you the function outside of it of what happens. Each one of these channels here will actually get grease from this grease circ and will fill these channels, not only lubricating things, but keeping things flowing through and all that. You have lubrication channels on the top. You have lubrication channels on the bottom. And you have lubrication channels on the side. That's what keeps everything smooth and going. When you pump the grease circ, it fills all of these. So when we're gonna go next and take this to clean, we wanna make sure that we get these nice and clean. You may even want to use a little pipe cleaner and all that, and then pump some grease back through this grease circ to make sure you've got clear channels and that you're getting that grease through all the ports in the chuck.
Can you show us an example of how the grease actually come through? I got a grease gun here.
Absolutely. You can see with just one pump where the grease came out onto the bottom side and on the top side of the chuck. So now we're gonna take this thrust plate off, we're gonna take the draw nut out, and underneath this draw nut, there's gonna be a ball and a spring. You just don't wanna drop and lose them because they're very small. You can remove this in the chuck body as you had asked for before.
Yes, because that's typically what I've done.
I like to have it out on the desktop just so I can make sure, and in the vise, I don't lose any of those parts.
That's why you put it in a vise.
Do we have to mark anything here?
No, we're okay.
Okay, all right.
We're gonna go ahead and remove the draw nut from that thrust plate. And this is the part where we said we wanna be really careful because we're gonna have some small little pieces we don't wanna lose. So we're gonna come in here, and on the side of this thrust plate, we're gonna go in and loosen this set screw.
Now, loosening this set screw, you mentioned there's a spring and a ball bearing behind there. So we gotta be careful how we take that out. Okay, all right, so it's not gonna shoot out.
And turn this over, and out of there comes the spring and the ball bearing. So these three pieces are critical not to lose. We're gonna keep these set aside for use later. Now that we've removed those pieces, you can see the draw nut, which attaches to the draw tube of the machine, and the thrust block are separated, and we can go and clean the rest of the chucks. Orville, obviously now we've got the parts all cleaned up. We brought them back to our bench. Now we're gonna go through the procedure to reassemble that chuck.
Okay, all right, let's get at it.
So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put back in those bolts that we used to slide around on the chuck face, just to help in ease of reassembly. So we can see one is now here, two, three.
Okay.
I just want to go ahead and take jaw number one that I know corresponds with jaw slot number one here and put a light coating of grease to help keep things smooth as I put it back together. Now obviously when we put the chuck back on the machine, we should go ahead and lubricate it just like it is brand new. This is just going to help us put it back together.
This is just for the assembly process.
Correct.
Okay.
So the first thing we're going to do We're gonna drop that first jaw in there. We're gonna slide it in. We're gonna push it back, make sure it moves nice and smooth. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and put in that second jaw. Again, we're just gonna put ever so slight amount of grease on there. See, it moves nice and smooth.
Yeah, that was nice and smooth.
And finally, we'll go ahead and do number three. And really, there's no point in over greasing it. Just trying to keep it clean to reassemble. So now we've got all three jaws moving nicely back in the main chuck body. So we're gonna go ahead and turn this back over. And we're gonna check on the sides. We're gonna see here, the number one matches with number one. We're gonna check on the side here, number two matches with number two. The next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna flip that chuck body back over. Again, making sure that we remember number one is in front of us, or however you like to, whatever number you wanna remember. This is where we wanna remember we didn't lose our small little ball bearing spring and set screw. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply a little bit of grease. Again, not that it's needed, it just helps keep things smooth, lubricated, and all that when we're putting together this piece. So we're gonna take the draw nut, which attaches to the draw tube inside the machine, which attaches to the hydraulic actuator, and slide that back in this thrust plate here, as such. Check that it rotates nice and smooth. Then we're gonna reinstall the ball bearing, the spring.
Now with that spring, Jay, do you need to add any grease to that or?
No, it's gonna be fine. Then we're gonna go ahead and put that set screw back in there. And we're gonna tighten this down. Now you cannot have that set screw sitting outside of the OD of this part because it's going to fit down inside this body. And so you need to make sure that that is below flush.
Okay, now can you over tighten that set screw?
You know, not really, but the easiest way to check is to make sure you're below and this still rotates smoothly.
Okay.
You can hear that ball hitting that detent. It's really nice and smooth. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna apply a small light film of grease back inside, and we're gonna reinstall the draw nut and the thrust plate. We'll take these 9 bolts. We'll tighten it in the vise just because it's easier to show, but you could also drop it in the chuck body and still you'll have enough to where it won't rotate and you'll be able to tighten it. But we're gonna go ahead and do it in the vise. So the normal torque value is enough here. You don't need to over torque. You know, hand tighten with a normal Allen wrench, you know, is gonna give you enough torque that you don't need to put a cheater bar on it. You don't need to do anything. Just get that nice and snug.
25, 30 foot-pounds of
exactly.
Torque.
Exactly. Yeah. We do want to make sure that that thrust or that draw nut rotates nice and smoothly still.
I can hear that detent.
Exactly. We're going to match up number one. It's still, you can see it on the side, it's still towards us. And we're going to make sure that number one here matches up. We're going to apply a light coat of grease inside the bore of the chuck and the outside of the thrust. Or the shifter. So again, matching number one with number one in here. And this is gonna be the hard part because this is an ultra tight tolerance and fit to get this to slide in there. So you may need to tap it ever so slightly to get it started. And you can see it just slid right in there once you did that. Now, the other side of it is getting your jaws to line up with your shifter slot. So now that we've aligned all that, we've got it pushed in there, we're gonna go ahead and push that jut down. Now you've got all three jaws in your wedge. You can move it back and forth and see that your jaws are moving nice and smooth. There's some finesse to it. There's obviously the rotational position of the 120, the 120 degree angle of each one, so you make sure that slides in there. And then you wanna find the right position of the chuck to fit in there. So you're gonna have each three jaws and you're trying to feel those and get that in there. So it's a little bit of a finesse game, but after time you can get used to it. So the last thing is, we've now got everything reassembled, got everything tightened, put a little bit of grease on there. We're gonna go back to the first thing that we took off, which is that adapter plate.
The adapter plate.
So we're gonna go ahead and make sure everything's nice and clean. We've still got our paint pen mark. So now we're gonna go ahead, realign where our marks were. Your chuck's been fully cleaned, serviced, reassembled, is ready to be bolted back on your machine and start making your parts.
So Jay, in the past we've had guys that complain about, you know, pressure issue and stuff like that. And the easiest thing for them to do is come over here and they just start cranking up the gauge and stuff like that. You know, how do you go into that, as far as what do you recommend?
Sure.
As far as that goes?
So that's really putting a band-aid on a problem that really isn't solved. So what you're doing there is you're actually overtaxing the hydraulic system, you're overtaxing your hydraulic union, you're putting more heat into the machine, because all you're trying to do is to get this thing to grip harder. And the reason that won't help is because the chuck isn't clean. So rather than putting that band-aid on, which can create a whole bunch of problems down the line of a leaking cylinder, of overheating, and different things along those lines, before you do that, take your chuck off your machine, clean it, see if it gets the grip force that's required when it's brand new, and maybe you'll never have to worry about cranking up that pressure and damaging your machine long term.
Awesome. We had a great time taking this chuck apart, cleaning it up. I hope you have as much fun watching this as we had making it, and thanks for watching.
Thank you.